Thank God for being here. Yes. Praise the Lord, everybody. Yes. All right. Yes. Y'all do know you before Trent was hitting key. Okay. Right here, we're gonna call to worship. Amen. Right now. So I'm gonna ask everyone to stand and repeat after me. I was glad when they said unto me.
I was glad when they said unto me.
The house of the Lord.
Let us go into the house of the Lord.
Make a joyful noise.
All ye lands.
Serve the Lord with gladness.
Come before his presence with singing.
Please remain standing for the prayer by Deacon Jerry Lane.
Amen. Praise.
As we bow our heads today, most heavenly and gracious Father, we are so blessed and heavenly favored that you allow us to make it through another week, Heavenly Father. Only through you that we are here right now, Heavenly Father, giving praise and glory for you, God. Keep us beautiful, well, keep us health and strength, Heavenly Father. We are thankful for the speaker of the hour, Heavenly Father. Keep strengthening and continue to give a word that may strengthen each and every one. Fill our cups up, Heavenly Father. Heavenly Father, we're thankful, Lord, that our pastor, Heavenly Father, is here for our service, Heavenly Father. We bless you for having him, Heavenly Father. We're thankful for all things that are done in your name. We pray today.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. You may be seated. And at this moment, we're going to bring to you, introduce to some. I think the majority of us know the speaker of the hour.
Amen.
I'm going to ask you to stand. The speaker of the hour, Bishop John Noble.
Preach, except they be sent.
Uh-huh.
As it is written,
How beautiful are the feet of them that preach the gospel of peace and bring glad tidings of good things.
All right.
Hebrews 6 chapter, the 10th verse, King James Version. For God is not unrighteous to forget your work and labor of love, which ye have shewed toward his name, and that ye have ministered to the saints and do minister. Happy 18th pastor anniversary to our chief apostle, the Honorable Bishop John D. Green. We love you.
But most of all, a holy man of God.
Oh, yeah.
Right here, we're going to have the biography of our pastor coming from Sister Vanessa Lang. Let's give her a big hand.
Want to say welcome. And want to say thank God we're here to celebrate and honor our pastor closing out this program for 18 years.
Amen.
To our pastor, we the members of Greater Love Temple thank God in the name of Jesus for our chief apostle and pastor, the Honorable Bishop John D. Green, son of the late Overseer Roosevelt and late Mother Florine Green. Bishop John D. Green is a real and dedicated man of God.
Amen.
For God has truly anointed and appointed our pastor to preach the gospel of Jesus Christ for this age. Through his preaching, souls have been saved and set free from the bondage of sin. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Therefore, Bishop Green shouts loud and clear, whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord with a repentant and sincere heart shall be saved.
Amen.
For there is no other name under the heaven given among men whereby we must be saved.
Yes.
And that name is Jesus. Bishop John D. Green is a man who loves God with all his heart, soul, and mind.
Yes.
And he loves his neighbor just as he loves himself.
Amen.
Which is a commandment from God. Oh, what love the Father has for us that he has gave his only begotten Son to die for the sins of the world. And Bishop Green loudly proclaims that on the third day, God raised Jesus up from the grave with all power in his hand to save this dying world. This is a great encouragement to the people of God. Knowing because Jesus lives, we shall live and make it to heaven. We the members here at Greater Love Temple want our pastor to know we love you.
Amen.
I say it again, we love you. And may God continue to use you to preach and teach his holy word. For through preaching and teaching, we are reminded eternal life can only be obtained through Jesus Christ. We pray that God will continue to bless our pastor, the Honorable Bishop John D. Green. We wish to thank Bishop John Cole, the Holiness Church of God, for all people and everyone who have gathered here today to help us celebrate our 18th pastor anniversary. God bless you.
Sister Lay.
Beautiful.
And now we're gonna call the praise team to bring us a few worship and praise songs. This is a part, only one of the parts though, for today, that everybody can take a part in. Clap your hands, sing your song, sing along with the praise team, stomp your feet, but come on y'all, I love the bright sunshine we get today. Is that all right?
Thank you.
That's why he's my everything.
Yes.
He gives me what I need.
Yes.
And more.
And more.
Somebody shout, and more.
And more.
That's one thing about he made me a promise that he'll give me what I need.
Right.
I found out he'll also give me some things I want.
Because
he's a good God.
Amen.
Amen. What a mighty God. Come on, God. I give honor to God and to my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and to our speaker for today, Bishop John Noble. Come on, clap those hands. And to his beautiful wife, my cousin, First Lady. Deacons, and we give honor to our singing mother, Mother Blake.
Us
the word of God.
Amen.
Yes.
Thank God for his wonderful gift.
Yes,
the Holy Spirit. We call it the Holy Ghost. That's what it says in the Bible. And I'm grateful to have it. I don't know how many in the world can be without it. But when you're going through and dealing with things, you need something to hold you. Why are you going through it? Can I get a witness? See, whatever you feel when it goes through, it may not be like mine. It might not be like yours. But we all go through something. But I'm glad for the Holy Spirit. Yes, we're certainly grateful to be here on this 18th anniversary. It's a great honor today. Bishop John David Green. Bishop, I was thinking about us, and I said, you know, for such a time as this, God had allowed us to be here to carry the work on.
That's right.
What our forefathers started, it was all because of God. Now they're going off the scene, but the work has not stopped. It's still moving on. Come on, somebody.
Did you want me?
Whatever you want.
Get the hat down.
saying any way you bless me, just want to say it. But I'll do something. I'm going to get out of here. I'm going to get out of here. I'm going to do something.
Oh. And not only that, but to lift you up for the great works that you have performed, that which you have done. And I'm so glad that you have done it for me. And God, you've done it for your people who trust in you, who believe in you. And God, I'm grateful again because of the celebration. Lord, as we know it's Pentecost today, but because of your Holy Spirit, that you allow, Lord, to come and dwell within us today. And God, I pray to you now that you will bless your people in a special way. Let your word go forth. Oh, God, resonate in our heart and, Lord, convert us and change us, Lord, to be better. Oh, yes, God. Lord, as your servant, use me, Lord. Speak, Lord, a word. I pray in Jesus' name. Your will be done.
All right.
I didn't ask for this.
Right.
Matter of fact, I was running.
All right.
But God did the call.
Yeah.
And he did the
issue.
2 Peter 1:3-10 says this, by his divine power, God has given us what? Everything.
Amen.
Is that word for you? Y'all just in line.
Come on now.
Giving us everything we need for living a godly life.
Come on.
We have received all of this by coming to know him, the one who called us to himself by means of his marvelous glory and excellence.
Come on, come on.
And because of this, his glory and excellence, he has given us great and precious promises. These are the promises that enable you to share his divine nature.
All right.
And escape the world's corruption caused by human desire.
All right.
In view of all of this, make every effort to respond to God's promises.
All right.
You want us to work hard. Supplement your faith with a generous provision of moral excellence. And moral excellence with knowledge. And knowledge with self-control. Somebody say, help me right there. And self-control with patience, endurance. And patient endurance with godliness. And godliness with brotherly affection. And brotherly affection with love for everyone. The more you grow like this, the more productive and useful you will be in your knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
But those who fail to develop in this way are short-sighted or blind. Oh my God. Forgetting that they have been cleared from their old sins.
All right.
Come on.
So Peter says, so dear brothers and sisters, work hard. To prove that you really are among those God had what? Called. And chosen.
All right.
Do these things and you will never fall away.
All right.
Somebody said, thank God for his word.
Thank God for his word.
My subject for today is working for me. It's working for me. Are you called and chosen? That's the question for you today. A plan that was put forward into motion long before you were ever formed in your mother's womb. A plan that is followed by anyone else would not come to fruition. There is a specific plan set aside just for you. It is for you and you only, and it was handcrafted by God himself.
Yes, Lord.
I love that. Because he uniquely designed us like no other. Good God Almighty. And I want you to understand something, because he himself has done this to lead you towards your potential. The potential that you possess was directed by God himself. And it is this potential that you will reach only if you continue to follow the path that he has created just for you. I want to say this as a question. Will you reach your potential?
All right. Like that.
We all have potential. But are you willing to reach it?
All right.
You have been chosen. Bishop.
Yes. Yes.
You have been anointed. Bishop. With the blessing of God. And gifted with the ability to make a difference in all who you find yourself near.
Alright.
I know if anybody's been near him, you certainly have been blessed.
Alright.
Anybody that's been listening to his word, you certainly have been blessed. in the direction, I'm sure you have been blessed. Can I get a witness? You are the head and not the tail. And it is through you that God seeks to reach your community.
All
right. The community right here. In every way he planted his feet, he will reach somebody in the community. He has appointed you to do great things throughout the world. He may not travel all over the world, but I love this and say, because Jesus told me, he said, greater work shall we do. And I always pondered and said, Lord, how can we do greater works than you? Because you're the greatest. He is the goal. Hello.
Yeah.
And I say this, but with technology today,
amen.
Yeah.
God already knew the time that was going to come. That now I don't have to travel all over the world.
Yeah.
But you know, media, social media, and I can reach millions of people and still spread his word and encourage and bless somebody who is willing to listen. He has called on you to make an impact, and I'm sure you have. He called all of us to make an impact. And oftentimes I say that when we look at a tombstone or the obituary, you see what it says, sunrise and sunset. But in between that is a dash. And that dash represents your life. And I want to say to you, what and who have you impacted since you've been here on this way? If God chosen you, you have work to do. Watch this. My question is to you today, will you answer the call? Everybody wants to go to heaven, but not everybody wants to answer the call. There's only one way to get there. You must be saved. He said, you got to come through the door. That door is Jesus. Watch this. I want you to understand something, because running this race and in this, you must understand something. As a believer, you are not left to your own resources to cope with problems. Anybody got problems?
Yeah.
Don't have you. We all got problems.
Yeah.
They do come, but I thank God they go. It won't be this way. Always. Even so, when you don't know the right words to pray, the Holy Spirit says, the Holy Spirit prays with and for you, and God does answer. Thank God he answers the prayer. With God helping you pray, you don't need to be afraid to come before him.
All right.
Because as I understand it, that when he was on the cross of Calvary, and the Bible said, when he said it was finished, oh my God, the temple was rent. The curtains fell down.
All right.
Which opened up the most holy place.
Yes.
Where only the chief priest was only able to go in and have a little talk with Jesus. But I want you to understand something. Because of that, he allowed us now to be as priesthood, to be able to go in and not be afraid, but have a little talk with Jesus. Can I get a witness? To come to Jesus.
All right.
Go to God. Because that's what he said.
Yes.
He said, whatever you ask the Father.
Yes.
In other words, talk to the Father. Commune with the Father.
Yeah.
But whatever your request is, make sure you ask it in my name.
Yes.
Hello. What is that name?
Jesus.
Jesus. Come on, church. Somebody say, Jesus. Look at this. When you bring your request to God, trust that He will always do what is best. I always say, whatever God does and whatever He says, you can bank on it.
Yeah.
You can count on it.
Yeah.
You can stand on it.
Yeah.
Because it's going to happen. His word is true.
Yeah.
For God works out all things, not just isolated incidents, for what? Our good.
Yeah.
Woo, no. This does not mean that all that happens to us is good. I've heard some people saying, I thought God was going to. So many calamities and things that has happened. I thought God was. That's people who are blind and short-sighted and lack of understanding.
All right.
But God will work out all things for our good. This does not mean that all that happens to us is good. For evil is prevalent in our fallen world. Hello, y'all.
Hello.
We can see it clearly. And it's bold. They're doing what they're doing.
Yeah.
Hello.
Here we are.
Shooting and the killing.
All right.
The craziness that we're seeing today.
Lord,
they got bold with it. And they don't care anymore.
No, they don't.
Bold. But we who are children of God gotta be bold likewise.
Yeah.
Because God is able to turn it around for what? Our long range.
All right.
I'm glad that because God has something in mind for all of us.
Yeah.
Understand that God is not working to make us happy. What? What? That made me happy. Understand. God is not working to make us happy. But I'm going to tell you what He is working on. He is to fulfill His purpose.
All right.
Some want to know what that purpose is. I want you to know also that this promise is not for everybody. For it can be claimed only by those who love God.
All right.
Yes, yes.
Notice I said love God.
Yeah. Yeah.
pray when things happen.
Uh-huh.
Pray always.
Always.
Yeah. In season and out of season.
All right.
Come on.
Pray for everything.
Yeah.
Pray about everything.
Yeah.
Pray.
By being filled with His Spirit.
Uh-huh.
And by doing His work in this world.
Yeah.
Peter said it.
Uh-huh.
By His divine power,
uh-huh.
God has given us everything. Somebody say everything.
Everything.
He's given us everything we need that pertain unto life and godliness,
uh-huh.
by knowing Him.
Amen.
For He's given us these great and precious promises.
Uh-huh.
One of them is the Holy Spirit.
All right.
Speak now.
The Holy Ghost.
Uh-huh.
That for us to obey.
Yes.
Because the word said that He came to lead us and guide us into what? All truth.
Uh-huh.
All righteousness.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
And not only that, but it will remind us of the words that Jesus have said.
Yes.
Second thing is, He gave us power.
Power.
Mm-hmm. To overcome sin.
Uh-huh.
To withstand the adversary.
Yes.
Because He's coming for you.
Uh-huh.
And anybody that's connected to Jesus, I'm saying to you, you are prone to be on attack.
Yes.
He's coming for you.
Uh-huh.
But He gave us power to win.
Uh-huh.
I heard somebody sing that song, I'm a winner.
Yes.
We gonna win.
We
I don't know about you, but I know I'm a winner.
All right.
Overcome, yes you can.
Yes.
You can do anything through Christ.
Yes.
He will strengthen you.
Yes.
Can I get a witness?
Yes.
With these promises, it enables us to share His divine nature.
Uh-huh.
Notice I said divine nature, not human nature.
Because
uh-huh. you know flesh wants to have control. It wants to do, it's my thing. And I'll do what I want to do.
That's right.
But when you change partners, and when you come out of darkness, and you come into the newness of life, you are now in the divine nature. And not human nature. Jesus.
Yes.
Not only that, but He enabled us to share His divine nature and escape the what? The corruption that is in this world. That is caused by human desire. I'm talking about the lust. Mm-hmm.
Come on.
Peter states, in view of all of this, that makes every effort to respond to God's promises. By adding to your faith virtue, a moral excellence,
yes.
high standards,
uh-huh.
we ought to have for ourselves,
yes.
as well as God.
Uh-huh.
Come on, somebody.
Yeah.
And with that, he said, add to that knowledge.
All right.
So what you don't understand, you got a preacher that will help you understand as well.
Yes.
Break it down for you. Make it plain. That's what the word said. And with that, add some self-control. Y'all know how we can get out of control sometimes. Because if you don't put it under control, self, the flesh, want to rise up and want to do His thing. But not only that, but He said you must put on patience. Bishop, I found out something.
Uh-huh.
Because as we celebrate even so the day of Pentecost, those disciples and others in the upper room, they had to wait. They had to be patient. Jesus told them, He said, you go and wait there.
Wait.
And tell the what? The Holy Ghost. And while they was waiting, they had to have some patience.
Yeah.
We're living in a day that people don't have patience.
Yeah.
I see it every day. And I want you to understand something, because whatever Bishop may say, he prophesied, he's speaking to your life. You better learn how to wait on God. This thing, it's got to be on the inside. Because if you have God on your side, and you have godliness in you, you're going to show some love. You're going to show some kindness. Hello, somebody. You're going to love everybody. And I got news for you. Even for those that don't look like you. Even for those who may not even be in your circle. But you still got the love. Because you don't know who it is that God may use you to bless them whose lives may be changed for the better. The more you grow like this, the more productive and useful you will be in your knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. But those who fail to develop in this way are short-sighted. They become blind. Not willing to see it God's way. Or from his perspective. Forgetting that they have been cleared from their old sins. I don't know about you, but I'm glad he cleared my sins.
Amen.
And he only had to do it once. So then, my brothers and my sisters, I'm asking you to work to prove that you really are among those whom God has called and chosen. He said these words, Peter said, if you do these things, you will never fall away. You will never fail. Come on, somebody. And even if you fall, you can get back up. That's what he means. You don't have to say that. But you can get back up. Because God, somebody say God, has chosen you and I. Chosen by God.
Yes.
Chosen for the high calling of a priestly work.
Yes.
Yes, Bishop. God called you for the high work of the priesthood.
Yes.
And you're doing a marvelous job. Lord, chosen to be a holy people. God's instrument. That's what he is. To do his work.
Ah.
was the goodness of God. He called me out of darkness into his what? Wonderful light. Right, is marvelous. To what the 12 others of the difference he made for you and I. From nothing, somebody said nothing, to something. When they told you, when you wasn't going to be nothing, but you could say, look at me now. When you was rejected, and from rejection, now I am accepted. I want you to understand something. Tell somebody, I am chosen.
Wow.
works.
Thank you.
If you love the Lord with all your heart, mind, soul, strength, come on now. Because I love it, he turns it around. Because any story, and I know y'all have too.
All right.
People say they've been on drugs and all kinds of problems, situations. And they said, God, they got real with him. And they said, Lord, if you really are God, you take this away from me. I'll serve you for the rest of my life. And God done it. And because you had the look enough to come to him and ask him for help, and God make it for your good. Put it all together. And in time, you come out walking like you know. It's working for my God.